Hey everybody, I'm finally getting to do this video. I've been really, really busy and have been a little behind in getting videos done like I'd want to. Like I know I've had a request to have a versus between my Fury and one of my Thunders, and I have had like zero time to get around to setting that up and doing that. I'd really like to do it, but I haven't had any time to do that. And I think I've had one or two other requests, and I've been a little late on being on time, if that makes any sense. Cause I'd like to do show new vacuums like right when I get them, but I haven't had any time to do that. Been doing a lot of work, lawns, working with the guy that owns the house next door, fixing up another house. Be going to, back to school soon and such. But anyway, so I was on the way to starting the job with the guy that owns the house next door. And it was trash day across the main road, and the trash truck was going down my street across the main road, because the street goes across in like an H pattern. But anyway, so to avoid the getting stuck in front of the trash truck, I made a right turn onto the next street over, even though going left would have been closer to the direction I was going. I knew there was no trash on that street. I'm like, you know what, maybe I'll just go down the other street and see if there's any trash. And sure enough, since I had to make a left to go where I was going, there was trash on the other side street. That's where I got these two vacuums. The Bissell is missing its dust, complete dustbin and all that. Hopefully the vac store will have one of those. I'm sure he gets rid of a lot of those machines, because they're just junk like that. Both machines are really, really, really clogged. It took me like half an hour just to clean out the clog and the Bissell, which was in the hose going from the floor to the wand and attachment hose. I mean, it was, the stuff was really, really stuck in there. Same with the Superlite. The whole thing from the brush roll all the way through the clog, the unclogged port was clogged up. Unfortunately, the little plate on the unclogging port is missing, and I forgot to put some tape on it to create suction for a little demo here. But at least I have some cords hooked up. I bought some thick landscape wiring, which I wired in for a cord on this Eureka so it would have a cord. And I put a cord on the little Dirt Devil hand vac that I got. And I'm going to put a cord on the little Ultra. And eventually, I think I'm going to put this orange cord on that Sunbeam canister. Don't know yet. All the new vacs, the four newest ones, and these two ones will be going in storage either in my dad's friend's shop or storage place. I don't think I have any more room for vacuums there. Lawnmower and stuff, that's going to be going there. I have room for that. Otherwise, some of the stuff might be going to the office, where I definitely know I still have room there. At any rate, I'll run these vacuums, even though I can't do much with that one. I'll turn it on for you just so you can see it. And I'll give it a little super light a run across the carpet, even though it won't do much not having any suction. Firework time already, and it's not even July. Pisses me off. And the power nozzle motor on this one is pretty weak. New vacuums. I hope some more roll in tomorrow as it's trash day again, and hopefully the day after, because that's trash day on the side of town where I got these. And I'll keep you posted with more updates. I think I got one or two other videos I'd like to get done. Hope I get that done today.